Next news is out of Utah, USA. Three girls stood up to a teacher who condemned a boy for having two dads. This is one of the saddest things ever. This little boy, fifth grade, very excited that for Thanksgiving he was adopted by his two dads. And he mentions this in the class, where then the substitute teacher goes on this 10-minute rant on how two men living together is a sin. It's gross. And she's just berating this poor little boy who just said he was thankful for being adopted by his two dads. Well, these three girls stood up and they were like, no, fifth graders, okay? And they're like, no, you can't say this to him. You can't act like this. The teacher was undeterred, so they left the classroom, grabbed the principal, brought the principal back where she was at. The teacher was escorted out unceremoniously, just escorted out of the classroom.
Wow, this has actually turned out to be a good news. I thought this was bad news, but it ended up being good news. So the teacher starts making fun of this poor little kid for having two dads. Three girls in the class stood up to the teacher, her or him, I don't know. Is it a woman?
Her.
And
I think it was a woman.
Okay, and she thought that she went and got the principal. And it's so amazing that these, how tone deaf these people are, that think that she thinks that of course the principal would be on my side, but then the principal escorted the teacher out of the school. Is that what happened? And she lost her.
Yep.
And she lost her job. That's amazing. Okay, guess great.
I don't know if it was a female teacher or a male teacher. I'm so sorry, guys.
Yeah.
It was a female teacher.
I thought so. Okay.
Okay. But that's okay. But what, how confident, okay, so how confident, why was she so confident that the principals were like, of course, these students, you know, two dad is sinful. Like, what was this, like a religious school or so? What made her so confident that the principal would be on her side?
I don't know.
It was a public school, actually. It was not religious.
I don't think she thought the principal was ever going to get involved. I think she thought she was going to stand up there, berate this little boy, tell everybody in the classroom that two men living together is a sin and is gross, and she was going to get away with it scot-free.
Wait.
But then these girls stood up, and they started trying to deter the teacher. Like, you can't say this. Don't put him down. And then when the substitute teacher refused to listen to the girls, they left and got the principal themselves. So,
oh wait, I think who got great. The teacher? The students got the teacher, or the students got the principal? Oh, okay. The students went and got the principal. I thought the teacher went and got the principal. So the students went and got the principal. Yeah. Okay. Good. No, I misunderstood the story. So these students, the girls, that's very brave of them to stand up to a teacher like that. Good job, girls. I mean, I hope that boy now feels more empowered than before, to see there, even if there's somebody in society that wants to treat you like this just because you have two dads, there are other people that will stand by you and defend you. That's pretty good, right? Yeah, that's nice. That's a nice, heartwarming story. And again, this is
Okay.
Yeah, go on.
Yeah, I was something to say, like, yeah, it's good news and all, but he's still the boy. He's still a fifth grader. He's still a kid. And what the teacher said, she went on a 10-minute rant. So that might have affected the kid somehow. Like, he could be thinking like, oh no, if I get adopted by my two dads, do I have to face this kind of people my whole life and stuff like that? So,
well, he might have
affected him negatively.
Yeah, but it might also. Yeah, I hope not. But it might also, if that's what the message that he got. Well, I think that's a good thing because he is going to face people like that all his life. But I'm glad that learning that also came. If he had to learn that there are going to be people like that are going to be attacking him for this all his life, I'm glad that he also learned at the same time that there are people that will stand by him and support him. You know what I mean? So at least he learned that as well. I don't know. I'm hoping he's okay. But by the way, before anybody says, like, but what about free speech? What about free speech? Again, this is a school. That teacher is still, like, if she lost her job, which is a good thing that she lost her job, she should not be a teacher. But this doesn't violate her free speech because she could still go outside and spread her bigotry in public without going to prison or anything else. Free speech doesn't mean that freedom from consequences, right? You're free to say whatever you want, as long as the government doesn't fine you for what you say, as long as the government doesn't arrest you for what you say, as long as if somebody wants to harm you in any way because of what you have to say, the government comes and protects you. As long as those things are happening, your free speech is not being violated. If you're not entitled to hold a job while saying whatever you want, you have a right to freedom of speech. You don't have a right to hold every job that you want while holding the opinions that you have. Losing your job is fair. That doesn't violate your free speech.
Atheists are under attack in many places. If they were Christians, their voices would be heard. If they were Jews, their voices would be heard. If they were Muslims, their voices would be heard. But they are atheists, and not many seem to be listening. Let's make it difficult for them to ignore us. We have built a global community, and now we are tearing down geographic, cultural, and language barriers so we can find each other and support each other. In the last decade, we have built the largest atheist community in the world. Now we're doing the same in other languages. With your help, we have started Atheist Republic in Persian and Arabic.
انضميت مؤخرا لأسرة Atheist Republic وحيصير عندي بودكاست باللغة العربية.
As we grow, we can dedicate more time, staff, and resources to start doing the same in Spanish, Portuguese, Malay, Bengali, Urdu, Hindi, and other languages. We are providing community, support, informative content, and amplifying the voices of those who need protection, especially in countries where people feel isolated simply for their lack of belief. We want to be there for them, and we are only getting started. Help us get there. Check in the description for ways you can support our projects.